everybody. I'm Tom's wife. Sorry about my appearance today. I have the day off. I don't know if everybody knows this, but we have a foster child. He's actually pre-adopted, but parental rights aren't terminated. So he's our foster right now. Hopefully once that court case goes through, then he'll be officially pre-adoptive. But our social worker is coming over today for a visit, so I get time off through the week. So I decided to take some hours this week today to get the house cleaned, because we were away all weekend, and I think the house is filthy dirty. Nobody else really agrees, but I feel 100% better whenever the house is up to my clean standards. So I am going to do some healthy cooking today. We're going to cook some deer meat in the crock pot. We've actually got some deer meat here. This says the neck. I have never crock pot cooked neck meat before. So basically what we're gonna do is put it in the crock pot with a little bit of water and some seasonings, and then I'm going to try my hand at making some paleo barbecue sauce. I've made some in the past and it turned out pretty good, but I've lost that recipe, so now I've got to make a new recipe. So I'm going to show you how I stew my deer meat, and you can use just a normal barbecue sauce, but we're gonna try our hand at some paleo barbecue sauce today. So I will show you how I get the crock pot ready, okay? Okay, so here's my crock pot. It is actually a wedding present that we got when we got married, which was 11 years ago. Good Lord. It'll be 12 years this September. So this bad boy has lasted us a long time. It says, if you see here, it says low and high. There is no low and high. Basically, it's high all the time. So I just discovered these things. I shop on Amazon Prime Pantry and discovered these slow cooker liners. So I've been doing this in here, and then you don't have to clean out your crock pot. You just need to kind of wash it out a little bit. So let's get this prepped up.
Wait, so don't mind the stain back here, because I don't.
Okay. So basically these liners are like super easy. Unfold them like this. They look like a big plastic bag. I don't know, it's probably not good for your meat to cook in these, but whatever. Means I don't gotta clean. Okay, so then I take about a cup of water, pour it in the bottom. I don't know why I do this. I mean, meats can cook in their own juices, but I think it makes the deer meat a little bit more tender. So I'm gonna take it down here. You were up on top of a Jif peanut butter granola bar box, by the way. So this is completely frozen. Still wrapped in the paper from, I think we got this process at Seavers. I'm not positive on that. But this is completely frozen. So see, big frozen piece of deer meat. I believe that's a bone or a ligament right there. And we'll get that out once it cooks down a little bit. There is quite a bit of marbling on it. Like I said, I don't know, because I've never really cooked neck meat before. So we're gonna see how this turns out. But basically, we're gonna pop it in here, just like that. And then we're going to turn it on high. Oh, gotta plug it in. Jeez, good Lord. Gotta plug it in, here we go. Now we're on high, lid on. Okay, so now, basically this is gonna cook for like 8 hours. It's gonna cook all day. And what's awesome about a crock pot is you can set it and forget it. So what I like to do when my meat is completely frozen, I don't like to season it right off the bat because it's frozen. I mean, you could basically like season water. But I wait a couple hours. If I'm home, if I'm not home, I just go ahead and throw my seasonings in. I add this here lately. It is Smokehouse Maple Grill Mates. It tastes delicious. For anyone that's eating paleo or Whole 30, there is a little bit of brown sugar in this. But that's the only ingredient that, I mean, the other sweetener is molasses, and you can have molasses. I think it's pretty well on your paleo or Whole 30 diet. So, I mean, a little bit of brown sugar, whatever. So this is gonna cook for a couple hours, and then I'm gonna come back and season it and I'll show you. Okay, so it's been more than a couple hours because I got to cleaning my house. It's really not soft enough yet to break apart. It's pretty I kind of rotated a little bit.
See, that's that bone right there that'll need to come out once it cooks down. But once it cooks down a whole lot more, I'll be able to get all that off. So, since I can't really break it apart, I'm going to go ahead and add some seasoning. This is the smokehouse sprinkle. I'm going to sprinkle all on top. I like to use quite a bit because when I break it apart later, once it gets soft, I will, a lot of that seasoning will be lost. And then this is just sea salt. And I put a little bit in the water. So I will turn this a little bit and get some seasoning on top too. And like I said, I've never cooked the neck meat before, so I'm really not for sure how tender it's gonna be. But we're hoping for some good stuff. Okay, lid goes back on top. Done!
Okay, so this might be the most ghetto camera setup I've ever did. Okay, we have a really awesome DJI camera mount thing that like stabilizes and you can go wherever, it'll track your face. But I can't get that going, so I basically cut a hole in an old Tupperware container, wrapped a towel around it, and then put my camera on a selfie stick and stuck it through there. The towel is to basically keep it stable. Who knows, the cat's up on the countertop, it might knock it over. But we're gonna start making barbecue sauce. Okay, so I'm gonna turn my my stove on. Little pot. I'm gonna start with some butter. I'm using Kerrygold. I don't think you have to use that kind. It's what I had. It needs to be used up. So a little dab of butter in the pot. Then we're gonna basically saute some onions. Okay, I'm super cheap and lazy, so I bought these already pre-cut up onions. I buy them, if I ever go to Walmart, which is very rare, I always buy like the green onions or the red onions. We have white onions here, but it's something new and different, and they're already cut up, and then I just use them for like every recipe I make that week, so it works out pretty good. So I'm gonna cook these down a little bit, get them nice and soft. Stove top. Okay, then I'm gonna add a little bit of garlic, but it's gonna work. Garlic, minced garlic, because again, I'm lazy. Throw that in there. Keep that cooking around. I have leftover sausage from this weekend, so I'm gonna throw it in there just because deer meat is so lean. I figure the sausage might add just a little extra fattiness to it. For the sauce. Then I'm gonna add, I think half a can of tomato paste. I'm really not sure yet how much tomato paste I'm gonna use. I like my barbecue sauce pretty tomato-y. So we're gonna see how this does and how it tastes. I'm gonna turn my heat down. Get a little steamy in here. Then I'm gonna add like, I don't know, some of the spicy mustard. Probably should have shook it up before I squirted it. I don't know. I'm just guessing. We'll see. We're just experimenting in the kitchen today. We're gonna see how this turns out. I don't know. It looks like 2 tablespoons, 3 tablespoons maybe. A little bit of paprika. And some balsamic vinegar. Just because it's so good. So, next, a little Worcestershire sauce. Pour that in there. I don't know. We're guessing. Give this a quick stir. It's getting a little hot. It's a little more hot than I want it to be. I keep turning the heat down, but it's not still too hot. Then I'm gonna add about a cup of water. We're gonna see how that does. We're gonna add a little bit of water. Make it a little bit thinner. I should whisk it. No, it's starting to mix. Water's just gotta incorporate, I think, in there. Oh my gosh, it kind of smells amazing. Oh yeah, we're rocking and rolling with this barbecue sauce. Okay, now for a bad word and giggles, we're going to add some sriracha for a little bit of heat. Just a little bit. Not a whole lot. There's kids eating this, so we can't make it as spicy as me and Tom would like to eat it. So looks good. You know, my go-to barbecue sauce was Sweet Baby Ray's, and it's a little more burgundy. It's not so, like, weirdly, I don't know what color that is. I forget whenever I used to paint what that color was called. Burnt sienna, I think. Burnt sienna. It's a little burnt sienna. Maybe for a little sweet, I'll add a little bit of molasses. I thought, well, I could have went with honey, which would probably make it more burnt sienna. This might actually make it more dark. A little bit of a Br'er Rabbit. I don't know what kind this is. I just got it at the grocery store. We're just adding some. We're gonna give it a little taste test here in a little bit. Ugh. Now I'll have to wash the lid of that, so let's mix that in. Give it a little taste. I don't think I want to use my garlic spoon. Gosh darn it. This will not quit boiling. I mean, you want all the flavors to marry, but I don't want it to like boil and get all crusty and weird. I need more tomato paste. Let's add more tomato paste, shall we? I like mine more tomato-y. That tastes really mustardy. I think I might have added too much mustard. And I think it needs more sweet. It needs a little bit more molasses, I think. This is gonna be the biggest pot of barbecue sauce ever. Because I'm just gonna keep adding to it until I like the taste of it. And who cares about anybody else? If they wanted it how they wanted it, they would have cooked. Stirring, stirring, stirring. I got the heat or the temperature really low now to try to get it to just simmer and not boil. I don't want it to boil. My stove looks disgusting. Oh, I should probably show you that. Don't look at my dirty pan and my dirty burners and all the splashing. I did a terrible job of trying to keep my stove clean before the people come over today. But that's okay. Okay, let's give this a whirl. Definitely needs salt too, so we'll have to salt this baby. Probably a little pepper, pepper, pepper. Mmm. That's better. That's real better. So let's add some salt. Where'd my salt go? Oh, I used it when I. Over here. And for funsies, let's add a little bit of this. Oh man, there's the meat. Look at that bone sticking out. Ooh, steam. See that bone sticking out? Now that is meat. Not that stiff. This is deer. We got not too long ago. So I added some of that maple smokehouse. Let's add a little bit of that, see what happens. So might just bring it over the top. Okay, let's try a bite. Let's see where we're at. Man, it's like vinegary, tomato-y, kind of like mustardy because we use the Dijon mustard. Then it's got a little bit of that sweetness from the molasses and that maple, smokehouse maple seasoning. And I guess this is a winner, winner, chicken dinner. Okay, so I'm going to turn this off now and it's going to wait until we get our deer meat out. To pour over that deer meat, and then I cook it off in the oven for, even though it's already cooked, I cook it in the oven for like 30 minutes at like 350, and then with the barbecue sauce get this crusty film on top of it. It's so good. Okay, we're gonna take the meat out of the crock pot now. Okay, so
meat.
It's some parts are really have already fallen off. I was kind of poking around on them a little bit. So I'm gonna get up the pieces that have fallen apart, kind of check and make sure there's no bones in it. And then I can kind of pull this apart like that. Looks like some pieces on the top are kind of tough, but I think it'll shred. Yeah, it just shreds apart. Like pulled pork. And I kind of just break it apart so it'll be like pulled pork barbecue kind of, but with deer instead. I dropped a piece on the counter. Good thing I washed this counter. Good thing. Okay, see, there's that tendon I was talking about earlier. Can't get much meat off that part because there's quite a bit of tendon there. there is meat on there, but it's gonna be more of a hassle to get it off. Bone in there. That's nuts. Have you ever cooked a neck before, Tom?
No.
I hadn't either. All that bone in there.
The neck right there.
That is the neck. That is so crazy. Look at all that marrow.
Yuck.
Oh. People would kill for that. Oh, I bet. You know what? My dad would say, that's tender part of the chicken right there. Turkey right there. That's the most tender part. Look at that bone, people. Oh, there's one more little piece of meat on there. That is so crazy. Ooh, I don't want that. It's kind of fatty. That is nuts. Look at that. There's like, look. You can see underneath here the, all that bits. Look at that.
Yeah,
that is crazy. I know, but I've just never cooked one before, so I don't know. Okay, so now I'm gonna get this barbecue sauce. And I might not use all of it. What, Isabel? Are you gonna? Hi. We're gonna kinda. Oh, you were looking at
the neck,
neck meat. The neck meat. I think Isabel wants her picture in though. Okay, I can definitely use more barbecue sauce. It looks pretty good, doesn't it? Okay, so it smells really vinegary now that it's like set in. Meemaw's baking pan. It did. It came from Meemaw's house. No, Grandma Bob. And I kind of flatten it out because I like it to get pretty crispy. And it's pretty saucy. So I don't think I need to add any more sauce. It's gonna be right here. Should I pour the rest of this on there? Do you want it really saucy?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
A little bit of that sausage in there.
I know, I saw that.
Well, I figured it needed to be used. We don't let it go to waste in this house. Okay. So, there is our barbecue deer neck meat. So, now I got the oven. I said earlier 350. But I've got the oven heated up to 425 because I'm going to roast these carrots, which is basically carrots. There's a lot of olive oil on this thing. Pour some of this out, maybe. Olive oil, honey, salt, and pepper, and roast them for like 20 minutes. So I figured since we've got the higher temp, I'll roast the deer meat with the carrots for 20 minutes. So here is the finished carrots and barbecue. See how it gets like that crispy bit on the top. And then if you, once you get underneath that, it's really saucy. So we'll see how it looks plated up with some, I've got some strawberries. They needed to be ate because they were about to go bad.
Here we go.
And yep. There's the plated meal.